Hey guys, and welcome back to Prison Architect, the gang's DLC. This will be our 6th season of Prison Architect, and this will be a bit different, as now it will be more of a tutorial than before, trying to teach new players how this game works. So let's go create a new prison. Prison gender, male, warden. I'm gonna choose one of the new wardens, Captain J. Locks. The best ones, if you want to choose just one that's best, Periwinkle, Pacifier, and Her. These are the three best in my opinion. I'm gonna choose Her as she's one of the new. Yeah, so she's minus is that staff require more rest, but prisoner offending chance is lower, so yeah. Then guard dogs, these are just like personal choice, it's just what they look, it doesn't affect any way. So I'm gonna choose all dogs, so randomly just when buying a dog handler, one of these dogs. No warden mode, ward size will be large, veteran initiative will be legacy, you know, we already had a prison with the Perfect Storm DLC, this prison won't be that. Starting season spring, gangs, medium, low is a bit too low, high is way too high, so yeah that. More lieutenants, you may think that higher is the harder one, but no it's the easier one, as this means how many prisoners in a gang you need before they can get a lieutenant. So 3 would be 3 gang members per lieutenant, 10 is 10 gang members per lieutenant, so I'm gonna stay at 10. Rat investigations, disabled funds, 30 grand like always, plot type, I'm gonna go with the default one, you can choose, it's not too much of a difference except the island plots. Fog of War always on, land expansion not needed, forests always on, failure conditions always on, criminal incentives will put off, as they're kind of annoying and yeah, already done multiple prison with those. Gang special reputations, yes, as this is a gang prison, I will try to teach how to reform those gang members. And I also want them to have special reputations. Then gang reputations, no. Events, yes. Prisoner transfers, yes. Temperature, yes. Staff needs. I've been thinking about it. I don't think I'm gonna. As you know, this is like a guide starter friendly, and Captain J Locks's 10% more rest is way worse when you have staff needs on, so I'm not gonna put it. I wanted to, but I'm not gonna. So that's our settings, if you want to copy them. And yeah, let's play. So first thing, like always, intake, number per day 0, and crank these all the way up. Why? Well, simple, then the available amount of these prisoners will increase, so you can, when intaking them, have more of them. Then grants, always start with basic detention center and administration center. I'm gonna give our workmen a bit of a job by cutting these trees, quite, not that many, like really not a lot, but that's fine. I'm placing a quick exports. As I plan out where we'll start the prison. Don't worry, planning isn't necessary, but I do advise for it. Oh. Yeah, not like that. So let's just take from the corner, go up here, and have it like that. And then the center of this is. It is 156, so 75, 78. That's the middle. It's the middle. 77, that's the middle. Okay. In the middle, I want to have, you know, quite a basic. Thing, so. A staff pathway here in the middle. Officers that will be 6x6 outdoors and they need to be 4x4. Officers are the first thing you need to build. You need 6 of them, so I'm gonna have the 6 officers be here. This will be a staff only area, so prisoners won't be allowed here. I also want there to be a couple of entrances from here, planning out some doors. So they don't have to go through that. Now that prisoners actually walk through, you know, the reception, to the reception instantly, it can be a bit further away. One thing also, actually, I'm gonna leave this as, you know, the deliveries. And then, that was mine wide. And then, this as garbage and exports. So we'll have garbage there, exports there. You don't really need to plan that much output, I feel like. A bit out is nice. This is 8 wide. And this is 9 wide, so let's make that 8 wide as well. And plan out a nice little entrance area. This really is, like I repeat saying this, this isn't necessary, but I'm just gonna do this. Get an idea on where we'll be able to build. Let's just... That's definitely enough space for the staff buildings, I'd say. So far, let's have it 4 wide like this. This can be our visitor, you know, area where visitors can come in. And then this is the middle, so this can be our entrance to the prison. I'm gonna make these 9 wide. I feel like that's enough. These are gonna be a bit wider. 9 from here. And that will be our starting planning. You don't even have to plan this much out, but I just feel like it's good to plan a basic, quite basic thing. So now let's build foundation brick. This is the very start. We'll plan out this, which is the staff only area. This can have staff door, just staff doors as well. This will be our entrance anyway, and here will be the reception, which we can also start building. That will of course have large jail doors as well. This will be the way the prisoners escape if they do. So yeah. Let's have max speed. From here we can again plan out some 4 wide pathways. And then here we can actually start building the prison itself. So we want a holding cell, shower, yard, kitchen, canteen to start off. Some of them can be just here for now. I mean, I think that could be a holding cell and that could be a shower area for now. Shower areas aren't necessarily needed, but that grant wants it, so I don't know. Actually, I do know. I personally don't like building a shower, so what I usually do is to go to shower and just make any area, because it only needs a shower head. So this can be our shower. The grant accepts it anyway and thinks that, yeah, that's a shower. I personally like having the showers in the cells, so the prisoners can personally use their own showers and don't get mad. You also don't need shower time, so yeah, I think it's just positives all around. Let's make these as offices. Offices need an office desk. Chair. And a filing cabinet. You can decorate it more later if you want to. One thing we also need to do is make ourselves an area where our utilities will go. I'd say this is an okay place for that. Maybe let's have... There are 5x5, the power and water is 3x3, so yeah. That is a working one. for example, that we can make the same thing over there if we want to. Also, one thing, fence the entire map off. We already planned out where the fence will go, one tile from the side. This will stop your prisoners from tunneling for a good amount of time, because they really, if the cells are, let's say, there, it takes a while to tunnel out. Max speed it out, doors, large shell doors there and there. Then let's buy our warden, we'll hire her. She unlocks us the bureaucracy where you want to start off with finance, after that maintenance and after that security. After finance is completed, start researching the extra grant. Utilities, let's get our power station and our water pump right there. Connecting the power there and having a water pipe go out like go out like that there. And we also can have a boiler right there which needs a large pipe connection and a power connection with hash, and then through that we can get hot water pipes. Then the reception. It's a quite basic room. All it needs is, you know, a few tables. Office desk and a chair. That's a functioning reception. They will only be there for a moment, so it doesn't need to be big. Let's also get the power up here, going like that. The workmen are currently working on the fence, as you can see, doing a good job. Then, should we start planning out our, for example, kitchen and canteen? I don't necessarily know yet how we'll do the entire prison. Well, obviously, because we just started it. But you know, I think we can start down here. This can be our starting place. So, a good tip is to just have an even number. So let's say that that's our gonna be our future kitchen slash canteen. And then even number again, even number again. That's our kitchen, for example. It's a functional kitchen. And then some sort of a canteen area here. We don't have to start off with something that big. But you know, we can just start off with having this as a canteen and a kitchen. Utilities, we also need power to here, and then a radiator to heat up this place as prisoners will actually be here. Let's get the hot water pipe going like that there. Then foundations, let's make this area next, it can be our holding cell, and then the kitchen canteen area. This will have a couple of jail doors for the canteen and an ordinary door for the kitchen. And this will have a large jail door right there for the holding cell. Here, what will we have? We'll have a kennel, a security and an armory. It's 18 wide, so 6. And 4, so six, five, and 5. Let's have this security, kennel, armory, for example. 5, 5, yeah. We got finance, so extra grant. We also got maintenance, groundskeeping, cleaning. And as you can see, we require the staff. So to complete our first grant, we hire an accountant. And that's the first grant completed. Also hire a foreman, because well, we recharged them already. And grants, what is next? Well, I personally say the new grant, positive energy, because it just built a yard and add wage bench, which we would already otherwise do, so it's a nice free grant. Also, what I'm next gonna do is the regime. So this is what the prisoners will do during the day. I personally recommend having 6 hours sleep. They only need 5, but they will most likely be awakened during night for a shakedown or a tunnel search, so you don't want them to be like get all the sleep they need. Then let's move this first it a bit here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 hours should be here. And this is quite a functional basic regime. You can add a bit of lockup in the middle like that if you feel like they're getting too much freedom. We can get the power here, and this will be our holding cell. The bug where it's not highlighted is still here for some reason. It only needs a toilet and a bench, but I personally like putting here actual stuff, as you know, if prisoners stay here, you want them to be able to, you know, actually be here. So that can be our beds. We'll have 3 toilets there. You can put showers about the toilets to save some room. And let's give them some bookshelves there. That's a quite nice holding cell. Radiator there, and we overheated with the power, so we need some capacitors. Let's start with 3. This should be a high priority, so we can get our power back on here. Still researching everything here. Utilities, power. Power should be coming down here. So this will be our kitchen and canteen. Planning. Remove that. Door hasn't been placed yet. Let's place the ordinary door there. It's already placed, but they haven't just put it there. Brick wall there. So this will be our canteen. And this will be our kitchen. The kitchen needs sinks, fridges, and cookers. We'll have 2 sinks there, 2 fridges there, and 2 cookers there. The sinks obviously need water, so we'll have water coming from up there. They also need hot water, so we'll have that coming from there. Can this be put on? It can. Okay, good. Let's take the rest of the planning out for now. The canteen needs serving tables. Let's have the serving tables like that. Tables. And benches. Oh, I accidentally took out the lights. Yeah, let's place those back. So, how do we want to place these tables? This works. They'll have benches around them. And we saved a bit of space up here, where we can put some of the things to take care of their needs. I'm personally gonna add... Oh, we didn't add space. Oh. Well, looks like they won't get anything right there for now. I mean, we can move this later. Actually, no, it's easier to move them now, so let's move them out right now. Benches. we want to give some things to do, like praying mats and gym mats, so they can exercise and pray. Those are some of my personal favorites. So 4 gym mats there, 4 prayer mats there, and then we can... What else? Maybe some foam boots. Right there. Then we need a yard, so... Yard can be quite basic, it can go basically anywhere. We'll have our yard for now. It can be right there. Let's also add those wedge benches, so the grant can be completed. There's the other grant. Okay. Program, not programs, grants. Let's go with the staff well-being initiative. So we need a staff room for that. We'll make it very soon. Where will we have our staff room? I mean, we could just make this a staff room and then that a small armory, but I think we need a larger one, so let's cut out a bit from there. No. Let's have this be... This is our security. Then that's... This is our kennel. And this is our staff room. Armory. Kennel. I mean, that works. So let's make this in order to get that staff room. Staff door right there. Oh, we don't have any lights in the kitchen. Let's add some. There are some lights for the kitchen. We also now need 2 guards, 2 cooks, and that grant is completed. After that, we have gotten a lot here. Okay, so let's go with these. Deployment intelligence. I know that's a lot. I haven't checked on that for a moment, so that's my bad. So next grant. Prison maintenance and short term investment. That's gonna cost a bit from the start, but it's gonna give 16 grand later. And then we need to have 2 janitors and a garden to complete other one. And cell block A. To make a cell block. Not necessarily needed at the quite start, but you know, a nice thing to have. I'm gonna fence this area off for now. As you know, we don't want prisoners wandering too far away. And we'll have a fence gate. We'll have a door right there and a fence gate right there, so they can get out. The staff members can get out, not the prisoners. What else to research? Nothing right now. The water's being connected. I think next up is the first cell block. So we'll have a pathway coming here. And I think this could be a spot for our first cell block. So cells will be 2x3. Not 2x3 indoor, inside. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's have it be 5 on each side. That can be our cell block. Then we can continue this up here. I want to see how far up. Is that exactly 4? That comes perfectly. Oh, actually no, I planned that incorrectly. 2 here. 5 there. 5 there. And then this is a 6 way. And I mean that can be a 6, right? Yeah. So this could be our first cell block. Some doors right there in order to get down here, and yeah. Foundations, brick. Let's start out with this half first. Walls, doors, large jail door right there. And that fence went a bit too much there. We'll demolish the fence there. I think that from here we can first dismantle this shower. It's not needed. Brick wall. Make this room a staff room. It only needs a white sofa and a drinks machine. Because no staff needs are on. And then we need 5 guards. Grant completed. Inmate health and well-being could be a good one. Psychology and health. What next? I think that could be for bureaucracy now. We don't really need anything else quite yet. Also, oh, one thing. I haven't fenced this off. Let's fence this off from there. From there. And let's skip a moment ahead. Okay, this is built now, so we can start making cells. Cells can be quite simple. Oh, it's a chief. I'll answer in a second. Let's make a cell. Normal bed, normal toilet. Shower above. Drain under. Cooperant confirms underneath any corrupted cards. Yeah, so with CIs you can know if your cards are corrupt. We don't have any CIs yet because, well, we don't have any prisoners yet. So there is really no way to know if our cards are corrupted yet. But let's get power into this first cell block. We'll have it come from here. Actually, this is way longer than necessarily. We'll have it come from here. Big pipe is already going there, so we'll just have water like this. We also unlock deployment, so we can now deploy areas. This will be staff only, no prisoners allowed. This will be staff only, all of this staff only. And this is the area they are allowed in. Also, is there any... Psychology hasn't yet been, but security... what next? Patrols is important. Staff vetting could be nice, so less corrupt guards. As, well, we don't want corrupt guards. You can also give like bookshelves to their cells if you want to. I think I will. Also, one thing that we totally forgot. I personally like to add boomboxes and radios to the canteen to deal with some of their needs. And boomboxes, radio helps with the we don't have needs yet, but recreation and boomboxes calms the prisoners overall down. Utilities, radiators are also needed here, so we'll have a radiator there and radiator there. Sure. Metal detectors, I recommend adding them to the entrances of cell block. Entrances of prisons, let's also move this back a bit, just a tiny bit. And to areas where metal can be stolen, so kitchen. We won't place it in the kitchen, we'll place it in the entrance of the canteen. So people, while they are going eating, they will also be tested for metal. The cell is built, so quick build, clone, and we can just... Actually, we... No. Quick build, since we didn't have the bookshelf built yet, so... Let's give these prisoners a bookshelf as well. Rotate and flip from F, rotate from R, if you didn't know, flip. Rotate, flip. Rotate, flip, like that. Flip. I'm gonna just build a ball right there. Flip. And that will be our first cell block. Health and psychology have been researched, so now we can have a psychologist. And then we need a medical ward. The medical ward can go right here. And we'll have a door for it right there. Utilities. Hot water. We should reach. And we also need hot water to the showers in the cell. In the cells and... For the radiators here. Did we place any? No, we didn't. So radiators there. And there. That should hopefully be able to reach. Is that the only water boiler we have right now? Looks like it. We can place more right there. Bureaucracy. Warden doesn't really... Education is not needed yet. I mean... Armory could be something to research, but... I don't think we are at that stage yet. So yeah, I don't think we need to research anything right now. Power. To the metal detectors, they need direct power. Let's have that power line go a bit there. Deployment is correct. We want a guard in the cell block, a guard in the canteen, and a guard in reception. Just, you know, stop any fighting from here, and stop any escapes from happening there. Should we have some yard time? I don't think it's necessary. Utilities. Water. Haven't connected it. Now this room is completed, we'll have it be an infirmary. So in case any fights happen, we'll be able to, you know, heal them. That's enough beds, and let's have two doctors. Utilities, power. Up there. You want a metal detector here, as they can steal scissors. You can see in the dangers what they can steal here. Knives, forks, and spoons. And here scissors. So any metal objects can be got with the metal detector. And we also want... I don't think holding cell needs metal detectors, I think it's fine. Also, one building we want here in the start still is a common room, so that will be our common room. So yeah. Grant completed. We got the infirmary done, one bed has been put there. What next? Visitation rights. Yes. This is why we are building the common room, so... Because it's necessary here, and after that we should build a visitation soon. This is kinda just following the grants in the beginning. As you know, you don't have that much money. I mean, we have a good amount to know. Not always that much. And yeah. This doesn't seem to be able to reach, so we'll have water boiler there, we need the big pipes there, electricity also, then we can have water coming, hot water here, everywhere. Common room is built, let's make it, we want, what was it, TVs and pool tables, right, yeah. And 5 phone booths, so let's have TVs. You want from a normal TV, you want 3x3 area of chairs. Their chairs are also used in alcoholics and non-anonymous alcoholics. What was the program's name? Alcoholics group therapy, yeah. Yeah, and then the pool table. Let's put the phones in the yard. I don't think the common room needs them, and is there any needs that we aren't currently meeting? Literature and comfort. I mean, sure, let's add a couple of computer stations. Why is it so hard to speak right now? They're kind of a luxury, but you know, we are nice to our prisoners and they'll be nice to us. The power went out, we don't have enough capacitors, so let's add 4 more. Make that the first priority. Deployment is still correct. That grant actually requires 2 TVs, so let's have another TV. Where would we have another TV? I don't know, not really anywhere, I mean. Can we just place that and remove it? Yes, we can. Okay. We can also now turn this on. And yeah. Grant completed. Grants, the next grant. Security procedure certification. 3 guards patrol routes. Patrol routes, we'll just have this yard be a patrol route for now. We are not gonna assign anyone yet to it because we don't have 10 guards and I don't think it's a smart idea to have 10 guards quite yet, but we'll have them soon. Don't worry about it. And as you can clearly see, we have a good starting place for our prison right now. We have 20 capacity, 60k, good grants completed. Every need should be met. Here you can see the needs. Bladder, bowel, sleep, food, safety, hygiene, exercise, family, recreation, comfort, environment, warmth, privacy, freedom. Clothing is one that we don't have yet, and luxuries as well. But those are some of the needs that we'll meet very soon and make things very soon for the prisoners that will most likely arrive in the next episode. But I want to thank you all for watching this episode 1 of the new series and a tutorial on how to start a very good and functioning prison. I thank you all for watching and I hope I see you again. Bye bye.